I am teaching you operation research, and that one LPP linear programming method. In that one I am solving the graphical method. Here LPP stands for linear programming problem. In that one a graphical method I am going to solve. This is the maximum condition they have given it, and these are the subjective constraints. These are the data they have given it. Now here greater than and less than plays an important role here. Now these terms we call as an inequality, right? Inequality in this box, inequality, write these quotients as it is here, x1 plus 2, x2 greater than equal to 3, x1 plus x2 less than equal to 4, next 0 less than equal to x1 less than equal to 5 by 2. Similarly this one 0 less than equal to x2 less than equal to 3 by 2. This is the condition they have given. Now inequality has to be converted to equality. Now equality, in the equality just you have to add equal sign, x1 plus 2 x2 equal to 3, x1 plus x2 equal to 4, x1 is equal to 5 by 2, x2 is equal to 3 by 2 in the equality. Next we call as double intercept form or point. Double intercept form or point we have to convert in this form. X divided by b, x divided by a plus y divided by b is equal to 1 form. Now this can be written in this form. That means x1 divided by 3 plus 2 x2 divided by 3 is equal to 1. We have to bring in this form. Similarly, x1 divided by 4 plus x2 divided by 4 is equal to 1. Here already, now see here, this can be written in this form also. Or you can leave it in this way, no problem here. If you want to convert it here, you have to convert into 2 by 5 is equal to 1. Or rather then, you have to place as it is here. Now convert here. It can be written as x1, 2 by 5 is equal to 1. And here, x2. 2 by 3 is equal to 1. Now here in terms of points you have to write it here. I will consider here x1 comma x2 here. Now x1, in order to obtain the x1 you have to substitute x2 as equal to 0. X2 is equal to 0 in this way. X1 divided by 3 plus x2, 0 you have to substitute in place of 2 is equal to 1. That means x1 is equal to 3. If you cross multiply, the x1 becomes 3. Now in case of finding the x2, you have to substitute x1 is equal to 0. Then the x2 will be 1.5. See here, similarly. X1 divided by 3 plus 2, x2 divided by 3 is equal to 1. Now you have to substitute 0. If you substitute 0, this becomes x2 is equal to 3 divided by 2 is nothing but 1.5. Substitute here. Similarly, in order to get x1, x2 has to be substituted 0. Therefore, it becomes 4. In order to get x2, x1 has to be substituted 0. It becomes 4. 4, 4. Now here, the x1 is nothing but what? X1 is nothing but here, 2.5. X1 is 2.5. What about x2? There is no x2. 0. Now x1 will be 0 here and x2 will be 3 by 2, which is nothing but 1.5. Now if the greater sign is there, then you have to write here. Now we call it a shaded region here, shaded regions, put 0 comma 0 in equation, not required, directly you can write in equation. Based on the greater symbol you have to write If it is greater, you have to write non-zero region, non-zero origin, original side. If it is less than, you have to write original side, original side. If it is greater, you have to write non-original side. If it is less, you have to write original side. Here it is less, again it is original side. This required in drawing the graph. Less is there, again original side. Original side. Now after completion, draw the graph based on this data. Based on the data, here the x and y is there. I will consider the xy here. I will consider scale 1 centimeter is equal to 10 mm. This one I will consider x, x1, and this will be x2, x1 and x2. Now go for marking. Scale 1 is to 1, 1 is to 1 here. Marking here, O is equal to 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and this is x1. This is x1. Now this will be x2. X2. Similarly here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now go for x1. What is x1? 3. 3 here. X2 is 1.5. 1.5. Draw a line from 1.5 and 3. 1.5 and 3. Now, it is non-origin. That means the perpendicular line, the arrow should be here. You have to draw the exactly 90 degree here in this way. 90 degree here. But arrow should be away from the origin. Arrow should be away from the origin. That means this is the origin. It should be placed perpendicular and away from the origin. Next is 4, 4. This is the 4. X1 is 4. X2 is 4. Draw the line. Draw the line here. Draw the line. Here the perpendicular line. See your original side. Perpendicular line will be towards origin. Towards origin. Perpendicular line will be towards origin here. Now first line I will consider as 1. And this one is I will consider as 2. Here write it here. 1, 2, 3 and 4th line. Now third line, x1 is given, x2 is not given. Therefore x1 is nothing but 2.5, here it is 2.5, 0, x2 is 0, you have to draw 90 degree vertical to that of x2. What about the origin? It is towards origin, therefore arrow should be here in this way, towards origin, arrow towards origin. Similarly, 0, 1.5. That means x2 is given, x1 is 0 here. Therefore 1.5, this is the 1.5. This is 1.5. Draw horizontal line. If it is 0. Arrow towards the origin. The outside is original side. Origin. Now we have to find out the feasible region. Now see here which is the common region here. Everything, this line and this line meets here. The three. The four lines are meet at this point. This is nothing but feasible region. This is the feasible region. We call it as a feasible region. Feasible region. Now find out the points. We have to find out A, B point and C point. Now B can be easily find out here. See here. It is 2.5, 1.5. From the graph directly, and C can be found. C will be x2 0, 1.5. Here x1 will be 0, x2 will be 1.5. 0, 1.5. Now we have to find out A. Now it is very difficult to find out A graphically here exactly. Therefore, see the intersection. Intersection. Now see here. This is the fourth line and this is the third line as per the data. Now see the intersection. Intersection occurs between 1 and 3. Write the equations. Equating 1 and 3 here. Now what is 1? Value of the 1. This is the 1 right here. x1 plus 2 x2 is equal to 3. Now what is 3? 3 is nothing. This is the 3. This is the 3. This is the 1. Now this is the 3. x1 is equal to 5 by 2. Now equate it with the help of calculator. Now go for calculator. Equation 1. Equate 1, 2, 3. 1, 0, 5 divided by 2. The answer is 2.5. 2.5. One more answer is 0.25. The value obtained is 2.5, 0.25. Now we have to find out the maximum yield. Now after completion, this is the next box, the next concept here. Here you have to write extreme points. Write extreme points. Extreme point coordinates x1 comma x2. Here objective function value. The max is, they are given in the problem, max. This equation we have to write it here. Z is equal to 7x1 plus 3x2. Now at O, what is O? 0, 0. O, 0, 0. At A, what is A value? 2.5, 0.25, which is obtained here. This is the A value. What is B? This is the B and this is the C value. B value is 2.5, 1.5. C value is 0, 1.5. Now, you have to substitute. This is x and this is y. This is x and this is x2. Substitute in this x1 and x2. The first will be 0. Now, second, 7 into 2.5 plus 3 into 0.25. The answer is 18.25. Now, next, 7 into 2.5 plus 3 into 1.5. Answer is 22. 7 into 0 plus 3 into 1.5. The answer is 4.5. Among this one, you have to select the maximum. This is the maximum. Right. At B, that is 2.25, 1.5. 22 is maximum. It is maximum. I am Santosh Gaidankar. Thank you very much.